Hi, I'm Kevin Murphy, and I'm the co-creator and executive producer and showrunner of Defiance.
Hello, my name is Brendan McCreary. I am the songwriter for Defiance.
My name's Bear McCreary. I'm the composer and music producer for Defiance.
Defiance began as a collaboration between a video game company called Trion Worlds and Sci-Fi Network. The basic premise of the show was aliens arrive in 2013, seven different races, all with their own backstories, enmities, histories, and alliances.
When I was brought on Defiance, the first question I asked was, what is this world?
It was a huge job because we were creating cultures, not only of what humans think is interesting and cool 35 years in the future, but also what happens when you mix in all of these different alien cultures. And for me, what most defines a culture is music.
And so unlike a show that takes place today and now in a non-science fiction setting, you need new music and you need new interpretations of that music, and frequently you need it in an alien language.
Typically there's only one composer on a show and a music supervisor to play songs, and between the two of them they can handle all of the musical needs that the show has. Defiance proved pretty quickly to be very different because there needs to be score, there are licensed songs, but there's also this third element. There's an alien musical presence.
There was so much of it in season one that Bear and Kevin were like, well, let's have Brendan write these songs or arrange these songs or produce some of these songs.
I brought my brother in because he understands pop music on a fundamental level, and I knew he would rise to the challenge of creating pop music that sounds like it originates from an alien race. So we worked closely with David Peterson, the language specialist who created these languages. We worked closely with Kevin Murphy, who understands these races and he created their backstory. The thing that's been most exciting for me to watch is the way that Brendan and Kevin have had a relationship that's evolved over the course of the series.
I'm terrible at music, and I'm the world's worst instrumentalist. Like, I learned enough guitar in high school to be able to get girls to, like, you know, touch me, but I know just enough about music to be dangerous and annoying and an irritant to those who actually really are brilliant at it.
Anytime he sends me lyrics or he's like, you know, I feel like this should be a wacky folk country song, and it's like, okay, I got acoustic guitars, I've got a violin, I've got a stand-up acoustic bass, I've got like a Tom Waitsy throat kind of vocal.
Every episode, we discover something new about the overall tapestry of music and culture that exists in this world, and it's an amazing opportunity. I don't know if we'll ever get to do something this cool again.
Kevin's imagination gets kind of focused into a sentence that he tells me, and then my imagination goes poof.
So the song Lonely Light, it's a song sung from the perspective of a soldier. And it's a Vatanis Collective soldier, an alien, who is singing to his loved one as he's about to go off and fight a war against the humans.
With Lonely Light and pretty much all the songs that Kevin and I collaborated on, he would write the lyrics and he'd come up with the mind frame of the artist who fictitiously wrote these lyrics in the world of Defiance.
What I really enjoyed about doing this was creating this character, the soldier who doesn't appear in the show. It's the character of, you know, created by the songwriter of this song, who is also not a character in the show, and creates this little one-act play about someone who is going to do terrible, unspeakable acts of horror, but he's going to do it for a very good reason, for love, for honor, for family.
And so that's how it kind of works most frequently. Kevin will write the lyrics, and then, you know, I just build the framework around them.
And over time, especially over the second season, Brendan and Kevin have collaborated directly and created a musical pop culture language for each of these races that now exists outside of the score.
The other favorite song of mine is All the Love That I Got, which is this Blues Brothers, rhythm and blues, like 70s R&B tune. Kevin was just like, you know, I want some kind of like old timey, you know, rhythm and blues type thing. So I just leapt at the chance to do this. You know, I've got horns on the track. I've got Wurlitzers and old school piano sounds and plucky guitars. And I brought in a singer named Zach Jones, this great soul singer from LA. And he just like sings the crap out of it. We put live drums on it. And so that was one of the most rewarding and exciting elements of the season for me. The covers of Defiance are one of the most exciting things, because I get to take something beloved that already exists in our contemporary world and sort of extrapolate it and filter it through 35 years of apocalypse and then drape it sort of melancholically over these very important montage sequences in the show. I'm very pleased with the result.
And I love now that fans have an opportunity to listen to that music on its own and to be a part of the Defiance universe in a new way. It's very exciting for me.
And we really came up with a very eclectic framework, and all of the songs were sort of filtered through the production mind of and the artistry of Brendan. So it's been really just an incredible team that we've built and we've gone along, and I cannot be prouder of the CD and kind of the work that went into it.